guys. Laying here, I thought I would do a small tutorial on resin fish painting for amateurs like me, because I'm an amateur too. I just want to go over the basics because it's not hard to do and you don't really need too much artistic skill at all to do it. I'm going by step, layer by layer, at least the way that I do it. Again, I'm not an expert, but I thought I'd go ahead and show you guys how I do it so maybe you can follow along because it's not hard. It doesn't really take artistic skill or anything. So what you need first is a little bowl. So this is a little ceramic, pretty sure this is ceramic, bowl. I got this at Daiso. This was $1.50. So it's super cheap and we're going to use this to actually do our resin in. The only other things that you're gonna need for this are tiny paint brushes. So paint brushes with not a lot of width to them, but definitely on the smaller side. And you're also gonna need clear casting resin. It's very important that this be clear resin and you need quite a bit of it. Obviously for this one, we're gonna need to fill almost the entire bowl with resin. So just think about that. Don't get jewelry resin because usually you get tiny little things and it's only gonna fill it up to here. So you're gonna need resin and you're also gonna need acrylic paint. I'm using cheap acrylic paint for this. You can get it anywhere. And yeah, that's all you really need is brushes, bowl, resin, and paint. And let's go ahead and get started with the first step. Alright guys, we're at our mixing stage. So when you bought your clear casting resin, you should have gotten two different bottles. One is your hardener and one is the actual resin. And they're going to be slightly different viscosities. So one's going to be super thick and the other one's going to be a little bit more runny. Unfortunately, some bottles I found are clear, like extremely clear for one of the bottles. What is this? This is... pretty sure this is the resin itself, but usually they're more clear than this. Some bottles are a little bit more yellow, kind of a shame. It's fine, it doesn't really discolor it too much, but obviously the clearer the better, the more watery it's gonna look. So when you have both your bottles, it should come with a little measuring cup or something to measure in. If not, you can get these like disposable measuring cups probably at any department store. Obviously they're the kind of things that you would like measure, cough syrup or something in, so they're like super easy to find. You need a little stick that you don't mind throwing out because you're going to be mixing it, and then a little bowl that you don't mind throwing out because you're going to be mixing it. This one you can try to clean as much as possible to use it again, but most of the time I find a couple uses and it's over with. Another thing that people do is they'll actually get two different cups and only use the hardener in one and only use the resin in the other. That way you never actually get hardened resin inside it because they're never mixed together, you know? So anyways, you want to measure and mix these according to manufacturer's instructions. You want to make sure that you're being completely safe. You know, it'll probably recommend you wear gloves, so you should probably wear gloves, maybe even a face mask if it asks for that. Just be careful. I'm not that extra personally, but I would definitely recommend it if that's what your instructions ask for. So first we're gonna do the very bottom layer of the resin. This one's gonna be kind of high up because you want your fish to be in the middle, kind of. You can want your fish to be lower, but I want my fish to be kind of in this area right here for its bottom layer. So I want the fish to sit right here. So I want to bring the resin up to that. And I'm just kind of guessing. You can obviously like do some math to figure it out. You could fill this with water and then measure how much water that is and then measure how much resin you need. You can do all that to figure it out. I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna kind of guesstimate. You can always add more. It's a little hard to remove it because when you pour it out, you're gonna get a line as if you had poured it out. So try not to do too much. So I'm just gonna kind of guesstimate here how much I need. Thank you. this can be pretty messy, so just be careful. So I went ahead and put, how much is that? 6-somethings of that. So let's pour that into our bowl we're actually gonna mix in. Some people actually do just freehand with their eyes measure. I'm not that good. I do it actually quite a bit, but I'm not gonna actually do it on camera because I'll definitely mess up and then I'll be like, wow, I just ruined this. Because you don't want any layers to be too sticky or else your fish is ruined. Okay. See, now this is why you would want two different measuring bowls, because when I put the part two in this, the more runny version in this, this residue is actually going to harden if I leave it in there. So that's why you might want to do two different measuring cups so you can get more uses out of it. Especially since it's so hard to get all of this out, so. So once you have them both together in your little bowl, that's kind of full, but you'd want to go ahead and start mixing them together, slowly stirring. The slower you stir, the less chance of bubbles being formed. You can already see I have a smidge of bubbles already forming. You don't want that. Most of them do settle and they actually come up, but if you start rapidly whipping this and getting air into the solution, you're going to have a very cloudy, cloudy layer, which will not give you the effect that you want. It won't be like little bubbles, it will be cloudy. You don't want that. So one thing I've found, there's different ways you can mix this, timing, going one direction then switching directions. Here's a little cheat sheet. I like to spin it and you can see as you start to mix them together it starts to get this cloudy color to it. Once it goes completely clear, that's when it's okay to pour. I have found that's like the best way to determine when it's done is when all of these like little squiggly clouds go away and it's completely clear. And I would even mix a little bit beyond that just to be certain, just so it hardens perfectly. And if it doesn't harden perfectly, you might want to look at the temperature of your home. You also want to look at the measurements to make sure your measurements are as close to equal as possible, or whatever. It's usually 99% of the time equal. I wouldn't be surprised if there's some resin out there that isn't. But you want to make sure that this part is done perfectly, or else you will have not the best results. You can see I'm kind of forming bubbles here. I don't want to do that. So mix slowly. See those bubbles right there? We want to make sure that we don't get any more of those, and we want to keep mixing until this fogginess goes away. So we're going to go ahead and do that. Now this, I'm using quite a bit this time, but that's just because I want to fill the bottom of the bowl pretty well before we do our first layer. When you actually start doing your layers, you're not going to be using this much, especially for a bowl this small. You're going to use probably about half this amount. So I currently, this was, oh gosh, I couldn't even tell you how much this was, honestly. But you can kind of see how much. I mean, I do most of this just by eye. There are ways if you want to make sure it's completely a good amount. If you don't trust yourself, you can fill the bowl with water to the amount you want, measure how much water you use, divided that in two, and that's how much of each part you're going to use. So it, when it's added up, it's the amount that you want. I mean, there's different ways to do this. I feel like we just want it in that general area over here, so in the bowl. So we don't need to be too careful about it. You can see it's getting even more cloudy. That's the resin and the hardener kind of sitting next to each other. And we want to just keep mixing until they're actually 100% mixed together. And as that starts to happen, it should go more and more clear. Changing directions a couple times will help that, but don't do it too rapidly that you create bubbles. So I found mixing with a popsicle stick is a lot easier. I couldn't find popsicle sticks, unfortunately, so this is, I have no idea what this is, this stick originally came from. But I got a ton of them. You're going to be throwing them out every single layer you do. You can't really wipe them clean. You can try, I'm sure you can get a couple uses out of them, but I find it so much easier to just toss them. Okay, you guys, you can see it's actually starting to get more and more clear right before your eyes. So we know we're slowly getting there. It just takes a long time. Obviously, the smaller solution, the quicker it will be to get there. And I'm actually looking down through here, through the sides. I can't exactly show you what the sides look like because, well, I can't tip this over to show you guys. But I can still see that there are two different solutions, kind of like an oil in water, where you can see the oil on the water. So we want to keep mixing until it doesn't look like that, and it looks like one solid, clear substance. So again, this is kind of how I'm able to tell when it's ready. Another trick while you're mixing, this bowl has small ridges on the bottom of it, and I'm kicking up some of that harder viscosity solution up from those ridges, and I can see it coming up, kind of like, again, that oil and water. I can see it actually being removed from those ridges. And if you don't get every solution on the sides, in the middle, in these ridges, you will have weird parts that might not cure correctly and they might be sticky. So again, make sure that you're actually dragging your stick along the edge to grab all of those bits on the sides, grab those on the bottom in the ridges, and make sure to once in a while mix towards the middle. And that's gonna really mix those two solutions together a little bit better. Thank you. Now, it's no shock that this is an extremely time-consuming way to do this. No shock at all, because after we pour this in the bowl, I'm gonna wait pretty much an entire day before I do the first layer of painting, because it takes a long time for it to actually cure and harden. There are certain resins that I hear you can actually cure with UV light. This is more of a tutorial for amateurs like myself, so I'm not gonna go out and buy UV light and resin. Another way you can kind of pass the time is you can cure a couple different bowls of resin at the same time. That way you have something to work on while another one's curing, and you can kind of paint for a little while, less than, 10 minutes before you start to cure your next layer. So that might be something you want to do. And look at that. Do you see how much clearer that's gotten? Let me see if you can see how clear that is. Wow, look at that. It literally now looks like water. You see, I got a little bit of bubbles in there, but those I'm sure will come out when I actually pour it. You can see a smidge of those lines. I don't even know if you can, but there's a couple lines in there of that, oil and water look, where you can tell the two solutions aren't completely mixed. So again, even after it's gone clear, let's mix a little bit more just in case. Make sure you're getting all those sides. Mix in the middle. Do big mixes to get all of it distributed. Watch where those little ridges are so you can work on those areas and move those around and mix them. I can see there's a couple little places over here. Here. Mix in different directions a little bit. And I think that's beautiful. I think that's beautiful. Let's go ahead and pour this. All right, once your resin is nice and mixed, that's when we can go ahead and pour it into our bowl here. See, it does have that slight yellow tint to it, but I think that's going to be okay. If you use a wooden backdrop, you're not really going to see that. So there is our resin. I'm just going to make sure that there's no pieces of hair or lint in anything in here. Got that little piece of lint. Nope, oh, that's actually part of the bowl. There's a little hair right here. right now. See anything else. So what you can do is, if you're afraid of any dust getting on top of this, and if anything does, it's actually going to stay on it because it's sticky. So it's going to stay in there. So you can actually cover this to prevent dust, or put it in a place that you don't think is going to get dusty. It's going to stay wet like this, then it's going to change to a sticky solution, and then it's going to change to a hard solution. So you're going to want to make sure that in its wet and sticky state, nothing gets on top of it. Just cover it. Don't put it in the freezer or anything. You don't want to mess with the temperature of it or anything like that. And we're going to wait a few hours to make sure that this completely cures. And then we'll go ahead and do our painting.